with another one. Welcome back. Excuse me. So this is game two of the Cubs and the Brewers. After that, blowout win. Let's see if we can look for redemption to win this game. But I know for the most part that I said in the last video that I'm going to be focusing more on batting, because that's where the struggle is at. So let's see if this pays dividends on this behalf. So 0-2 in the count. Way outside the strike zone. Like I say, I always try to go for the kill, but it's not that easy. Especially since the games have advanced. So there's the first strikeout right there. I didn't think for anything it was going to catch that one. I thought that would have went, like, literally ahead of him. Hard to reach. So now it's two outs. Nobody on. This is interesting. I wonder if it looked like it was going to be a strike, like on the inside. That would have been interesting to see if he didn't swing it. All right.
He's out.
That's the end. 1-2-3. Brandon Woodruff.
Leading off for the Cubs, the second baseman.
Finally got that in the strike zone. So now it's 3-1. Let's see if he goes for the walk. That was a very bad swing. Very bad. So there's the first walk of the game. It comes at the bottom of the first. That was a good swing. Probably just early. Or too late. So now it's 0-2, and here's that count. Of course. Swing it down for a ball. Ooh, hit by pitch. It's automatic take base. So now we got nobody out, two men on. That first pitch goes to a ball. Late, but it was still a good swing. Outside of the strike zone. Strike two. That could have been a ball. That could have been 3-1. On the count, but it's 2-2. Yeah, that was iffy. That's very iffy, but they called it a strike. A real ball. So now there's a full count, 3-2. Take the walk now. The bases are full. Loaded bases with nobody out. Struck him out looking. I always talk about it in 2K, like when it comes down to me playing with the Kings, and in the fourth quarter you have to keep the mental mistakes down. And I looked at that when I swung on the upper side of the corner of the strike zone. That could have been a ball, and I was just relentless. I just let it go, and that wasn't very smart middle thinking on that behalf. And now he got struck out, so it's two out. Bases are still loaded. And with that pitch, it was a strike. So now, it's really no excuse. You really have to get a hit. You know, at this point now. Because they allow the walks. And strike two. Ball two. Dude, struck him out looking, didn't benefit anything from the bases loaded, so, yeah, that's frustration right there. Very well can understand that. Still scoreless going into the top of the second. Easy play for Trey Mancini. Get the first out of the top of the second. Strike. No ball. Caught him swinging. And that's what sometimes most players, most pitchers would do. Try to get it outside of the corner to try to sell it to actually force them to swing. Some batters are smart about it, some are not. So you want to try to get every inch of that corner of the strike zone as much as possible. All right, headed down to the bottom of the second. Still scoreless.
Leading off for the Cubs, the first baseman, Trey Mancini.
It's tough. You know, you finally get a, you know, a hit out of that bat, but they catch one out. That's tough. Could have kept that low. Would have been a ball. Yeah. That was a good pitch. That was also a good pitch now. End of the second inning and into the top of the third. Still scoreless. Interesting up to this point. On that corner, got that strike. That was a good pitch. So this pretty much be a fly out. For out number one. Yeah, that was way outside the zone. Fooled him. Fooled him real well. He paid the price. I think that was a four-seam fastball. He paid the price. So now they got a 1-0 lead. He made that swing look so easy. Made it look so easy. Strike two. Using my 2K skills again. Ridiculous. There you go. Bottom of the third. But not before home run. Now the Cubs lead 1-0. I'm sorry, the Brewers lead 1-0. It's just hard to swing that baseball bat. It's just hard to make contact with it. On the outside of the strike zone. So now it's 3-1. This is good. And there's the walk. Two consecutive walks. Way to keep it even instead of getting behind 2-0. That's a good job right there. It's 2-1. Still 2-2 after that popped up foul. Went to probably to the stands or rolled into the bullpen. Not bullpen. The benches. There you go. Full count. 3-2. At this point, he's going to have to strike him out. Let's see what happens. And he did. You don't want to load the bases up at that point. And so he called him. He called him looking. Just straight call him looking. So it's still 1-0 with the top of the fourth. One and one. That's going to go foul. If any pitchers watches this video, is it really that difficult being a pitcher? Like, I know, like, arm fatigue plays a role in consuming energy and stuff like that, but in the mental and physical aspect, is it hard? How difficult is, you know, when you're pitching? What's the experience like? Let me know in the comments on what happens. Let me know. And as we just witnessed. Inside the park home run. Critical errors. Now it's 2-0. Oh, good catch. That's the way to hustle. That could have been a double. Could have been maybe a double or triple. So, the way to hustle by Ian Happ. Very good. So one out, nobody on. And first pitch took it low, down into the zone. It's 1-0. 1-1. Once again, it's a good job. You know, do not go behind 2-0. Keep it 1-1. Let's see if we get a strike here. Nope. That was a ball. Got fouled. Strike two. It's your opportunity. You don't want to go full count here either. There's nobody on. There's one out. Ground out. That's fair. So now it's two outs. This is a good strike. Yeah. Tipped foul. Now the count's 0-2. Now let's check out this 0-2 pitch. I always go for the kill. And I did. Strike three. Now we're headed to the bottom of the fourth. So coming up at the bottom, at the end of the fourth, there's a message for me and Darren. I'll show that next at the end of the fourth. So here we go. So, not playing, when I'm playing the game, I'm really kind of oblivious, just trying to, you know, play. It made me wonder, like, doing all these intentional walks, well, not intentional walks, but all these walks, it just makes me wonder that there's a strategy behind that. And if there is, it's definitely working. It's definitely working. Counts 1-2. Ah, 2-2. First out of the inning. Another bottom of the fourth. One out. One man on. Way up high. Took that opportunity to swing. Can't get mad at that one. He almost hit him. All right, so here's the 2-2. Now it's a full count, 3-2. All right, so it's foul. We continue with the count, 3-2. So let's see what the next 3-2 pitch is going to be. Oh, hit by a pitch. Automatic walk. Even though it was still ball four, it would have been ball four, but it got hit by a pitch. So no matter the circumstances, if it was 2-0, 1-0, 1-2, you get hit by a pitch, you automatically walk. So 1-2 out. I'm sorry. I think it's 1 out. Yep, 1 out. 2 men on. Strike 2. Strike 3. That's all I'm looking. So let's see if there's something we can make out of this with 2-1, 2 out. Tip foul. And look like ground out. All right, the message.
You know, sports figures have to live life every day, and they have to be a part of racial injustice and social justice and all of this, all of the things that are going on. And they have the need to reach out to the community. I think it's important that we all sit down and realize that outside of these athletes' uniforms, they're human and they're actually dealing with mental issues too.
With the whole ordeal with Shaq and Kobe when Shaq left.
Yeah.
And it was just like, oh, Shaq can't do this without Kobe. Kobe can't do this without Shaq, or Shaq could do this better than Kobe, and Kobe could do this better than Shaq.
And if this don't start off with Trae Young, then there has to be some problems. And I would really start considering making some major changes.
Right. Yeah. Yeah.
Major changes.
MP.
It's first down. Scrambling in the pocket. Christian Kirk again. No answers from my man. All right, so welcome back. I just realized that I'm missing the top of the fifth through the top of the sixth. And it's fine. I'm just going to leave it as that. It is what it is. And they did score a bunch on this, if you've seen. Now it's 8-0. So we're going to keep it like this. I know next time I'm not going to miss nothing like that. Like I say, it's just a learning curve, but it's okay. Don't trip. Another base hit. Couldn't get to the ball in time, so that's another base hit, so. That's good. It's very good.
Up next to the Cubs, the catcher,
Yan Gomes. So I'll probably put the put that up way high. Now it's easy to catch one out. So now that is the six. I'll probably put it the top of the fifth through the top of the sixth. I'll put that as a little extra content. And I'll just put it out there on YouTube. And that'll be the end of that. There won't be no commentary for that. It'll just be straight embarrassment at that point. So. It's the hustle. It's the speed. What is what's going on? My goodness. The strike. Now the count's even at 1-1. Strike two. Fly out. So we'll see what happens in game three of this series. Can we, the Cubs, finally string a win? Wow. Now they're gonna score. There you go, 9-0. That was the final score from the first game. 9-0. But can we actually get some strings of win in game three? So we'll find out next time. But as of now, this looks like this is a runaway game. Like I said, anything is possible, but this just looked like a runaway game. Got lucky in that count. So that's the end of the inning. Now it's the seventh inning stretch. We can ready to prepare for the bottom of the seventh. So there go the Brewers bullpen. They are probably going to make a switch here within the next inning or two. So we'll see. Woodruff already allowed 2 hits, but it's not allowed no runs. So that's good for him. The low corner there. It got out of the strike zone. Ow! Yeah. Check swing. That the check swing can be an actual blessing in disguise, and it could be an advantage. Man, that was tough. Two outs. Struck him out swinging. Fly out. It's the end of the seventh. Now we're ready to hit the top of the eighth. Milwaukee's running away with this one.
Leading off for Milwaukee, the designated hitter, Rowdy Tellez.
They say he swung, so he struck him out swinging.
The left fielder, number 33, Jesse Winker.
Way outside of the plate. Over 34,000 people in attendance to today's game. Interesting. Ah! Look like they say they got him swinging. Or it could have been right at the very low corner of the strike zone. And that's what they probably actually called, come think about it. Same man, I think that's the same man that hit the homer back in the fourth, I think it was. I could be wrong, I can't really read from where I stand on OBS. All right, so we're going to hit the bottom of the eighth. Struck him out swinging. 9-0. Brewers. Right off the pitching change, gets hit by a pitch. So instead, what I'm actually going to do is, at the end of this game here, I'll just go ahead and put the clip for the top of the fifth up to the top of the sixth on this also. Just put it out there and that way I wouldn't have to put it out again at some point. He's furious. Christopher Morel got struck out swinging. He's pretty furious about that. I guess struck out again. Struck him out again. There we go, top of the ninth. So he swung, so that's strike two. Strike three. One out. So we're going to have one more chance after this when we hit the bottom of the ninth. We're going to go from there. right. Struck him out. Great hit to the bottom of the ninth. And once this is done, I'm going to get off of here. And I'm still going to show the top of the fifth and the top of the, through the top of the sixth. So I appreciate everyone taking the time to watch this. I appreciate everyone's support. Very, very, very appreciated. If you haven't already, go ahead and subscribe to our channel, like and share our videos. And if you don't do all of them, we understand completely. Just appreciate your support. Now you're in the full count. Could let that go. That could have been a walk. Yep. Got him looking. Up next to the cup, the catcher, Young. Ooh, he swung that early. You could tell. Out number two. Some of these swings are just not smart. Look, they're going to be 2-0. Now it's 0-2. And that's the game. The Brewers won 9-0. They allowed Cubs 2 hits. So, that's that. I appreciate everyone's time. I appreciate everyone watching. Catch up with me on another one. I'll probably have another baseball game for you, or have another 2K game for you, or Madden, either one. But I appreciate everyone's time. Next, I'm going to show the unshown clip of the top of the fifth all the way to the top of the sixth, or top of the or bottom of the seventh, something like that. But I appreciate your time. Catch up with me then. Until then, I'm out. And enjoy.
Left fielder, Jesse Winker. The first baseman, number 2, Luis Urias.
No ball. One strike.
The batter number 7, shortstop, Denzel Watson. Third baseman, Christopher Monroe.
No ball, 2 strikes. One, 2.
Leading off from Milwaukee, the right fielder, Tyrone Taylor. Up next from Milwaukee, the second baseman, Bryce Terang.
Hee-haw! strike. No ball, two strikes.
The designated hitter, Rowdy Tellez.
One. Ball two. No balls, two strikes.